perjury sort cases. First is lump examination. Lump examination, examination of a lump. Examination of a lump is a component of in almost every surgical clinical examination. Sometimes you may be asked to spot diagnose a lump with just inspection. Given below is a rough guide to examination of lump. First is inspection, that is sight, size and shape. Then skin overlying the lump, scars, signs of inflammation, puncture. Then palpation, surface smooth or irregular, edge well or poorly defined, tissue plane, mobility or fixity, that is skin attachment and attachment to underlying structures. Consistency, soft, firm or hard. Cross fluctuation, only if soft to firm. Transillumination, only if fluctuant. Temperature and tenderness, reducibility, pulsatility and palpable lymph nodes. Now how will you present? There is a hemispherical shaped lump over the left lateral aspect of neck, measuring 5 cm into 5 cm in size. The overlying skin looks normal, its surface is smooth and the edge is well defined. It is mobile and not attached to skin or the underlying structure. It is soft in consistency, fluctuant and transilluminant. It is not reducible or pulsatile and there is no associated lymphadenopathy. If you are confident enough, make sure that you give a rational presentation excluding the possibilities one by one for more marks. Now these are the few pictures. A lump in the scalp, a cystic hygroma in a child, osteoma and exostosis. How do you elicit the skin attachment of a lump? Using the thumb of the examining hand, the skin over the lump is stretched in two directions perpendicular to each other. If the skin is freely movable over the lump is not attached to the skin. Why pinching the skin over the lump is not the ideal way? This method is not accurate as the lump may be attached to the skin in a point other than the site of the pinching. How do you elicit fluctuations? First, the lump should be fixed between the two feeling fingers, the index finger and the thumb of one hand, and press on the lump using the index finger of the other hand. If you can see the feeling fingers moving apart with each press, it is fluctuant. This same technique of examination should be carried out twice in two directions perpendicular to each other, that is cross fluctuations. If it is fluctuant, what does that mean? That means the lump is cystic. In other words, it contains fluid, but lipomas can show pseudo fluctuation due to fat cells. If it is transilluminant, what does that mean? That means the fluid inside is clear and does not absorb light. Some lumps are brilliantly transilluminant. Now lipoma. Lipoma explanation: sight commonly over the front and the back of the chest, size is medium to large, shape is hemispherical, skin scar present or absent, it indicates the recurrence. Surface lobulated, edge is well defined, tissue plane freely mobile, slipping sign present, not attached to skin or underlying muscle. Try to elicit the tissue plane of the lipoma by contracting the underlying muscle. When the muscle is contracted, if the lump becomes prominent, a subcutaneous lipoma. If the lump becomes less prominent, an intramural lipoma. Consistency, soft to firm depending on the nature of the fat within it. Now fluctuant, that is pseudofluctuant, and transilluminant may be transilluminant. There is a hemispherical separate lump measuring 5 cm in diameter over the right scapula. It is not tender, the surface is lobulated and the edge is well defined. It is freely mobile and not attached to skin or the underlying muscle. It is soft in consistency, fluctuant and transilluminant. So my probable diagnosis is a lipoma and I would like to offer him surgical excision under local anesthesia if it is cosmetically unacceptable. Now this is a picture of lipoma. What is a lipoma? It is a benign tumor that consists of mature fat cells. What is Durkheim disease? It is characterized by multiple painful lipomas. Can they undergo malignant transformation? No, but liposarcomas can occur de novo. And what is the treatment of lipoma? Usually by reassurance, but surgery is offered if the patient complains of pain or if it is cosmetically unacceptable. It is removed by either simple surgical excision under local anesthesia or suction lipolysis after obtaining the consent. Sebaceous cyst examination site commonly over the scalp and hairy areas, not in the palms and soles. Size medium to large, shape hemispherical, skin punctum, 50% cases, infected, erythema, tenderness, warmth. Now surface smooth, edge well defined, tissue plane always attached to skin, not attached to underlying structures. Consistency soft to firm, fluctuant, transilluminant, not transilluminant, thick sebum, lymph nodes, infected or not. Now presentation, there is an oval shaped lump measuring 5 cm to 4 cm in size over the right side of the forehead, 2 cm above the eyebrow. There is a punctum on the overlying skin and there is no surrounding erythema or the worm. Its surface is smooth and edge is well defined. It is attached to the skin and not attached to the underlying muscle. It is firm in consistency, fluctuant and not transilluminant. So my diagnosis is an uncomplicated sebaceous cyst and I would like to offer him surgical excision under local anesthesia, but if it is infected, patient may need to undergo general anesthesia. This is a picture of sebaceous cyst. Punctum is clearly visible here. What are the histological type of sebaceous cyst? Epidermal cyst or trichelial cyst? What is Cox peculiar tumor? When a sebaceous cyst is left untreated, it grows bigger and gets infected and ulcerated. This is known as Cox peculiar tumor and it clinically and histologically resembles a squamous cell carcinoma. Can they undergo malignant transformation? Yes, but very rare. What are the complications that can occur? Infection, ulceration, sebaceous horn formation, calcification, malignant transformation. What is the treatment of a sebaceous cyst? If not infected, simple excision under local anesthesia is done. If infected, incision and drainage is done totally under general anesthesia, but some surgeons prefer local anesthesia for small ones. An elliptical incision is used encircling the plankton. Now, dermoid cyst, site commonly over the midline, that is forehead, neck, trunk, behind the ear, posterior auricular dermoid, over the lateral eyebrow, that is external angular dermoid. Now, size small to medium, shape hemispherical, skin overlying scar, implanted dermoid, no punctum, not a serious cyst, surface is smooth, edge is well defined, tissue plane not attached to underlying structure, congenital or inclusion dermoid cysts do not attach to skin, but acquired or implanted dermoid cysts are attached to skin, consistency soft indentable, fluctuations may be fluctuant, and transluminescent not transluminescent. If you are given an external angular dermoid at the end of your examination, ask the patient to blow forcefully while his mouth is sealed and nostrils are pinched while you are palpating the lump. For expansibility, if it is expansile, it might indicate intracranial communication of the dermoid cyst. Now, what is the presentation? There is a hemispherical separate lump measuring 3 cm in size, bisecting the lateral side of the right eyebrow. There is no punctum or scars on the falling skin. Its surface is smooth and edge is well defined. It is not attached to the skin or the underlying muscle. It is soft in consistency, indentable, fluctuant, and not transluminant. Clinically, it does not increase in size with maneuvers, which increases the intracranial pressure. So, my probable diagnosis is an external angular dermoid, and I would like to offer him surgical excision under local anesthesia after exclusion of intracranial extension with skull X-ray and CT brain. So these are the two pictures, that is posterior auricular dermoid and this is external angular dermoid. What is dermoid cyst? It is a skin line cyst deep to the skin in the subcutaneous tissue. What are the two types of dermoid cyst? Congenital dermoid, that is inclusion dermoid due to failure of the fusion of skin dermatomes, and acquired dermoid, that is implanted dermoid due to forced implantation of the skin in the subcutaneous tissue following injuries. Where do inclusion dermoids occur? Along the lines of the fusion of skin dermatomes, they can occur anywhere along the midline, commonly over forehead, neck and trunk. Other specific areas are lateral eyebrows, that is external angular dermoid, and behind the ear, that is posterior auricular dermoid. Where do implanted dermoids occur? In areas which are prone to get injured, such as palms and fingers. How do you differentiate between it from a sebaceous cyst? No punctum, not attached to the skin, that is inclusion dermoids. How do you treat complete surgical excision under local anesthesia after excluding intracranial extension in suspected cases by skull X-rays and CT brain? And lastly, ganglion. Ganglion site is commonly over the dorsal of the hand and foot near the joints. Size small, safe, hemispherical, skin scar present or not. Surface smooth, edge well defined, tissue plane not attached to skin. Check the mobility by contracting the underlying tendon, that is, the ganglion is on the dorsal of the hand. Ask the patient to maintain the fingers in extension while you are applying resistance by downward pressure on extended finger. Meanwhile, assess the mobility of the lump both vertically and horizontally. Ganglion's horizontal mobility, sideways movement to the tendon is reduced when the muscles of the relevant tendon is contracted. Consistency is soft to firm depending on the tension of the fluid within it. Fluctuant may be difficult, elicit due to its size. Transluminescent, brilliantly transluminant, clear fluid. Now, presentation, there is a hemispherical spherical lump measuring 1 cm in diameter over the dorsal of the right hand. Its surface is smooth and edge is well defined. It is not attached to the skin but to the underlying extensor digitorum tendon. Its horizontal mobility is restricted when the tendon is contracted. It is soft in consistency, fluctuant, and brilliantly transluminant. So, my diagnosis is a ganglion of the extensor digitorum tendon, and I would like to offer him surgical excision under general anesthesia in a bloodless field. And this is a few picture: ganglion in extensor tendon, ganglion in flexor tendon, and removal of a ganglion. Then, question answer: what is a ganglion? What are the differential diagnosis? What is a ganglion? If a cystic swelling related to the synovial lining of the tendon sheath and it is believed to occur due to myxomatous degeneration of the synovial sheath, what are the differential diagnoses? Bursa, protrusion of the synovial cavity of the arthritic joint, other skin lumps is lipoma dermoids. What do ganglion occur? Commonly over the dorsal of the hand and foot, as well as in the palmar aspect related to the flexor tendons. How do you treat, that is, complete surgical excision under general anesthesia in a bloodless field? How do you create a bloodless field with a pneumatic tourniquet? What are the complications of the surgery? Recurrence, damage to the adjacent nerves and vessels, wood related complication. What is the risk of the recurrence? Around 5% to 20%, fairly high. Now the next thing that is important, that is the scrotal lump examination. Scrotal lump examination, take constant exposed well. Remember to examine the contralateral hemiscrotum, and for a coexisting inguinal hernia, which is not uncommon, palpate the spermatic cord to differentiate scrotal lump from an inguinal scrotal lump. Scrotal lump, hydrocele, epididymal cyst, cyst of the cords, inguinal scrotal lump, inguinal hernia, usually indirect. Check whether you can feel the testis separately from the lump. If yes, check whether there is a distinct gap between the testis and the lump, cyst of the cord or not, epididymal cyst. If no, it is usually a hydrocele, but in lax hydrocele, testis may be palpable due to small amount of the fluid. Stabilize the lump against the thigh or using your fingers of both hands and elicit cord fluctuation. Stretch the scrotal skin and keep a pen light away from the testis to look for transluminescence. Transluminescence will not be elicited across the testis. Examine the contralateral hemiscrotum as well. Get the patient out of the bed and look for a coexisting inguinal hernia and a varicocele. Hydrocele, he is having a lump confined to the right hemiscrotum, which is fluctuant and transluminant. The right testis cannot be separately palpable. The left hemiscrotum and the testis are normal and does not have a coexisting inguinal hernia or a varicocele. Epididymal cyst, the present is having a lump confined to the right hemiscrotum, which is fluctuant and brilliantly transluminant. The right testis is separately palpable and there is no distinct gap between the lump and the testis. Cyst of the cord, he is having a lump confined to the right hemiscrotum, which is fluctuant and brilliantly transluminant. The right testis is separately palpable and there is distinct gap between the lump and the testis. Now these are the picture. This is hydrocele case. This is transluminescence of a hydrocele. This is transluminescence of the epididymal cyst and epididymal cyst being operated. Now, what are types of the hydrocele? Primary hydrocele, that is idiopathic hydrocele. Secondary hydrocele, that is lax hydrocele due to testicular tumor, torsion, infection, trauma, or infection following inguinal hernia repair. Do all hydrocele transilluminate? No, chronic hydrocele are not transilluminate due to calcified sac. Why do we operate on hydrocele? Consummatically unacceptable and interfere with the intercourse, liable to trauma and the infection. What are the surgical procedures available? Jagulis procedure, the sac is inverted, and Lord's procedure, sac is plicated. What is the management of an epididymal cyst? Reassurance is a choice in young due to risk of the postoperative subfertility. Surgery may be indicated in elderly in the presence of the larger painful cyst. What are the main types of the testicular malignancy? Teratoma, that is young, less than 30 years, seminoma, older, more than 30 years. How do you manage them? High ligation orchidectomy using a transligation inguinal approach. Transcotal approach is avoided due to high risk of the skin contamination. What are the causes of the painful scrotal swelling? Testicular torsion, epididymal orchitis. Now, next examination is the breast examination. Breast carcinoma, take consent, provide adequate privacy, ask her to sit down first, expose up to the waist, ask the patient on which side of the lump and lumbus and whether it is tender before you touch. Use a cloth to cover the lower torso and chaperon. Number one, expose fully and look the breast asymmetry, skin changes, erythema, ulceration, pure orange appearance, and nipple changes, deviation, retraction, destruction. Ask to raise both upper limbs and look for skin tethering. Don't forget to inspect the submammary areas. Ask the patient herself to squeeze the nipple if she complains of a nipple discharge and check whether it is bloodstained. Then ask her to lie down and put her both arms behind her head. Palpate the normal breast first using the flat of the fingers. Palpate six areas, namely the four quadrants, subareolar area, axillary in order. Then palpate the contralateral breast, determine the size, shape, consistency, surface regularity, and the margins of the lump. If the lump is not palpable, ask the patient herself to locate it for you. Check the skin attachment of the lump while in the superior supine position. Then ask her to sit down again. Look for deep structures attachment. Ask her to keep her ipsilateral arm on the hip and press against waist when asked to. Check whether there is a reduction in mobility. When the pectoralis major muscle is contracted, proper contraction of the muscle is confirmed by the palpating the anterior axillary fold and the other hand simultaneously. Second, assess the axis in both axilla. Ask the patient to rest her arm relaxed on the top of your as shown in the picture. Now palpate all the axillary lymph nodes groups, that is anterior, lateral, medial, posterior, and central and apical. Assess their consistency and mobility if palpable. Then finally palpate for supraclavicular lymphadenopathy, dress her up and thank her. Now presentation, how will you present? At the end of the examination, come to a clinical staging depending on your findings. On inspection, there is no breast asymmetry, tethering, any skin or nipple changes. She is having a lump in the upper outer quadrant of her right breast, measuring 3 cm, 4 cm, 4 cm size. It is hard in consistency, irregular in shape, and margins are all ill-defined. It is not attached to the skin or the underlying muscle. There is a hard mobility. Mobile solitary lymph node in right axilla, in the anterior group, left breast and left axilla are clinically normal. My clinical staging is T2N1MS, and I would like to complete the triple assessment and proceed. Now few images, that is, this is the purely orange appearance, this is the nipple retraction, this is picture of Paget's disease of breast, this is examination of the axilla, and this is the mammogram of the breast here. Now few crossings. First is, what are the differential diagnosis for a breast lump? Breast carcinoma, fibroadenoma, fibroadenosis, fat necrosis, breast ascites, and breast cyst. How would you investigate the patient? Triple assessments will be done to complete it. FNSC or true card biopsy, excision biopsy, USG mammography of form of both breasts. If FNSC confirms it is a malignancy, do you still want to do imaging? Yes, it must be done to exclude multifocality and to detect impalpable lesions in the contralateral breast. What are the mammographic features of a breast CA? Structural distortions, peculiar lesions, microcalcification. How do you stage breast CA? TNM staging, T-staging is less than 2 cm, second is 2 to 5 cm, 3 more than 5 cm, 4 any size lump, attached to A, 4A is attached to chest wall, 4B attached to skin, 4C attached to both, and 4D is infiltrated breast CA. N staging, no, 0 is no lymph node, 1 mobile ipsilateral axillary lymph node, 2 fixed ipsilateral axillary lymph node, and 3 is ipsilateral supraclavicular or internal mammary nodes. M staging, MX unknown metastasis, M0 is no metastasis, M1 is metastasis. Breast cancer. What are the contraindications for breast conservative therapy? That is, multifocality, pregnancy, extensive diffuse microcalcification more than 5 cm or large relative to the breast size, poorly differentiated CA, cancer, any contraindication to radiotherapy. How do you manage breast CA? Surgery, conservative or simple mastectomy, radiotherapy, chemotherapy, doxorubicin, hormonal tamoxifen in young, aromatase inhibitors in elderly, biologic, trastuzumab for the HER2 plus breast CA. Now, how do we manage axilla? Sentinel node biopsy, axillary node sampling, axillary clearance is level 2. How do we manage a histologically confirmed fibroadenoma? Reassure if less than 4 cm and less than 25 years of age, but 3 monthly assessments are needed, which is typical in most clinical settings.